Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today is going to be a makeup tutorial, and I'm super excited. This is a Hollywood glam soft cut crease with a red lip. I couldn't figure out what I wanted to do or call this. Like, it's kind of like pinup, I guess. This video isn't going to be super long because I did one eye prior to doing this side that I was filming, so that makes it a little bit easier for you guys so you're not sitting through and watching me like do my whole face for 45 minutes. So I hope you guys like this tutorial, and if you guys want to see how to achieve this pinup glam look, then just keep watching.
So I guess we are jumping right in, guys. We're jumping in with Barcelona Beach. This is from MakeupGeek, and it is one of my absolute favorite starting shades with any makeup look I do. And we're just kind of cutting the crease with a Sigma E21 brush. And I'm doing this with my eyes open, because if you do it with your eyes open, then you're going to be able to see what it's going to look like. If you do it with your eyes closed, you're not, it could look absolutely terrible. So now I'm just taking a small like pencil brush and a little bit more of that Barcelona Beach, and I'm kind of just blending that out so we don't have any crazy harsh lines. Now going in with the same Sigma E21 brush and a Morphe number 26 shadow, we're just repeating the same exact process that we did with the Barcelona Beach. We're kind of just cutting the crease a little bit farther down, and this is going to help with like a nice seamless blend. So it's just going to be like a dark to light transition from the crease all the way up to the brow bone. And the last shadow we're taking is this black shade by MakeupGeek, and this is Corrupt. I swear to God, guys, I don't know if you've ever tried any MakeupGeek shadows, but this is probably the blackest black I have ever used. So I just went sparingly, barely touching my lid, and it gave me like a nice gradient, and now I'm just going to blend it out with that small pencil brush and make sure we have got no harsh lines, honey. So now I really wanted to cut my crease. I went in with the shade Vanilla from the Anastasia Contour Kit. And this small, really precise brush, to be totally honest, I have no idea where this brush is from. But you can use like a MAC to something that everyone else uses. And I'm just kind of packing this and cleaning up any of the lines that I may have made with the other shadow. I just wanted this to be super clean and super crisp. Now taking KatVonD's Tattoo Liner in Trooper, which is my absolute favorite liquid liner. It is literally so precise. I have never gotten like such a clean line with any other liner I have ever used. So it's super hard to like do liner on camera, guys, so I tried my best. I can try to get a liner tutorial together if that's something you guys are super interested in. Just let me know down below. Now taking Duo Lash Glue, which is my go-to lash glue, except it literally smells horrible. And I want you guys to watch my face as I put that glob of glue on there. Alright, so I'm waiting for this to dry since I put a little bit more on than I expected. I'm going to be throwing on some mascara, which is the Benefit Roller Lash, because I always want to apply mascara before my falsies. I will never apply after. It just ruins them. So I'm setting my lashes in the center of my eye first with my fingers. And then what I will do is I will go in with tweezers and I will set the end first, and then I will set the front. It just makes it so much easier so you know exactly where the front has to be. Now you guys know what it is. It's time to prime. So this is my favorite primer. I've went in this with so many times. This is the Makeup Forever Smoothing Primer. And it has silicone in it, so it really helps with oil reduction, so that's why I'm obsessed with it. So I'm just applying it all over my T-zone, wherever I get like super oily or my pores are like really out there, like I just don't want them to show. Going in with a different foundation today, I'm going in with Dior Airflash in the shade 201 and my go-to foundation brush, which is the Sigma F80 Flat Top Kabuki. You guys know this brush has been my favorite for so long. I kind of wanted more of like a natural, like skin-like finish in this tutorial, so that's why I went in with this foundation. You guys know that I love the NARS All Day Luminous, but that one sometimes is just like too heavy and too cakey, so I just decided why not change it up and go in with the Dior foundation. If you guys have not tried this, it is a little bit expensive, but it is really worth the money, and I've had this for so long, and I'm maybe 3/4 of the way done, so I've gotten my bang for my buck out of this foundation. And now we gotta cover those dark circles, which are more apparent after you put foundation on. I swear to God, I look 20 times more dead than I did before. So I'm going in with the Naked Skin concealer, and this one is in fairly medium or light neutral. And then I'm going in with a damp beauty blender, and I'm just gonna kind of press this and bounce this into the skin. I really don't want to move the product around. I kind of want it to just mold and meld into my skin. That's gonna give you more of the coverage you're looking for, and it's gonna give you that more smooth and flawless appearance if you're pushing and melding it into your skin. Now you know I gotta set that or I'm going to crease like a monster. I'm setting it with two of my favorite powders. They're both from Anastasia, and one is banana and one is vanilla. And I swear to God, I go through these powders more than anything that I've ever went through in my makeup collection. I have literally went through two banana shades, and one is literally on its way. And this is my first vanilla shade that I'm going into, and I'm gonna need to repurchase. So I'm jumping in with just a little bit of my foundation powder, which is the NARS All Day Luminous, and I'm kind of just placing that everywhere that we didn't set the concealer. So this is just going to give me a little bit of added coverage, just in case a little bit of my redness is poking through or this foundation wasn't full coverage enough. Now I'm contouring with the Fawn shade from the Anastasia Contour Kit, the powder one, and it's the light. Fawn is my absolute favorite shade. It's probably the best shade to contour with because it's gray toned, but it's not like gray to the point where it looks like you're bruised. So I love this. I'm just dusting this all under my cheekbones and around the perimeter of my face. And then I'm also taking Hoola bronzer by Benefit and this big fluffy brush, and I'm kind of just going over the contour but blending a little bit higher, and this is just going to give a little bit of warmth to the face and give you like a little bit more of like a sun-kissed look. And now I'm taking the vanilla shade and I'm kind of just cutting the contour a little bit and making it sharp and clean. Taking Warm Soul by MAC and a MAC 229, I'm just kind of dusting this on my cheeks. This is like a nice orangey warm blush, which is my absolute favorite for the summertime. Taking Soft and Gentle also by MAC, I'm just going to dust this on the high points of my cheeks, a little bit above the brow, and a little bit on the nose. This is just going to highlight. This is my absolute favorite highlight of the moment, but I have so many, so I guess it doesn't count. So yeah, just dusting it everywhere. I want to be glowy. Going in with that Barcelona Beach shade that we used on our eyes first, I'm taking that on the pencil brush, and I'm just running that under the eye. I don't want this to be super, super smoky, because I want the focus to be on the lashes and the cut crease, but I wanted to just add a little bit of dimension under my eye so it can kind of complete the look, you feel me? And then I'm going to jump in with the Benefit Roller Lash Mascara and just apply some mascara to my bottom lashes. And I got a little bit of mascara on my nose, you guys can see it right there, but I cleaned that right up. Now onto the lips, and I'm taking my favorite lip combo of the moment for red lips, and I'm taking Dose of Colors Black Rose, and I'm using that first, kind of all over my lip, and then I'm going to go in with KatVonD Outlaw, and I'm just going to focus that in the center, going to kind of give like an ombre effect to the lips. It's just going to give more dimension, and I don't want it to be super, super dark. If you guys can see, Black Rose is like a really, really, really deep burgundy maroon red, and I didn't want it to be super, super, super dark, so I lightened it up with the KatVonD shade. As you guys will see, I'm going to go over the liquid lip a couple times, and I do this because I want to make sure it is super pigmented. If you guys can see, it's kind of like patchy. It's darker in some spots, lighter in some spots. I want it to be a super even coat, so I'll go over it multiple times until it's even enough for me, and then I will be satisfied. So I'm just outlining my lips. I like to do that last. I kind of learned this from Nikki's tutorial, so hey girl, if you're watching, you're probably not, but I'm just saying if you are, this lip trick is from you. So now taking that Outlaw shade, I'm just popping this in the center of the lip, not too far out, and I'm just gonna work it in by blending it in with my top and bottom lip, so I'm not using as much product. Girl, you gotta save on your product. And then because liquid lips are super messy, I'm just going in with the foundation powder, the NARS All Day Luminous, and I'm taking it on this concealer brush, and I'm kind of just cleaning up any messes that I may have made. I don't want to go in with any liquid since I've already set everything with powder. I don't want it to cake around my lips. So I'm just going in with the powder that I used to set my face and clean this up the best that I can.
So much for watching this tutorial. I hope you guys did enjoy, and if there's any other tutorials that you guys want to see or anything you guys want to see, just let me know down in the comments so I can gather some ideas for upcoming videos. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I have to tell you. I will be in New York City next weekend, so that is the 25th, maybe. So if any of you guys are from the city or you guys will be in the city, let me know in the comments and maybe we can like meet up, take pics, you know, because you know you will see me at Sephora, MAC, Bloomingdale's, all of those places. So yeah, let me know in the comments or on Instagram, and I will see you guys all in my next one.